we see anything, immediately we think that they are also going to attack this attributive presumption only. It has secreted the tools for defense. So it has come out of error. It has come out of two errors. One is the error from the inner circumstances. Second is the error from the outer circumstances. Inner circumstances, we used to suspect people. Whenever we suspect people, we think that they are going to attack. Then, whenever really we are thinking the same thing, which we are also experiencing, that lot of people are attacking us frequently, then the outer appearance in the society, that also makes our defense mechanism stronger. More or less, we suspect about people and we think that they are going to attack. That is known as the defense mechanism that is bought out of our inherent nature. Second is coherence defense mechanism. We have seen two or three people stealing from us, we are seeing two or three people attacking us. So immediately, consequentially, we will think that certainly they are going to do that. So inherence and coherence, these two things are the major powers of mind which brings. Inherence is to think that it may happen. Coherence is as it has happened yesterday, as it has happened to somebody else, it will also happen today and for me. It is known as coherence mechanism of defense and inherent mechanism of defense. So this is the basic thing. And this type of coherence mechanism and inherence mechanism that has brought about insecurity, theory of uncertainty, theory of impending dangers or anticipation of dangers at any time, theory of overestimated security. There are two people, totally irresponsible or not bothering about anything at all. Those people are relinquished nature. There are two people. One is a renounced person, second is an irresponsible person. These two people, na bibheti kutaschana, these people, they are not afraid of anything. So that is entirely different. But there is a caution mechanism in which we try to think about something is going to happen. This feeling of anticipation of some sort of error in the society, error in the form of a terror, error in the form of terror and danger in the society, and also juxtaposition of instinctive imbalance as well as attributive presumption of our own characters with other things, it has resulted in defense and resistance mechanisms, which have been now augmented by technology, which has been broadened by national borders, which has been now universalized by international collaboration in wars and various other unwanted disruptive activities. So it has been widened, deepened and broadened. It has been widened by national borders. It has been broadened by means of international scenario. It has been deepened by technology, and this is what it is going on in the forms of war and the resulting conflicts. And the consequences in the form of a total never-ending turmoil to the society, posing an never-ending threat to the lives of the people, causing total insecurity. So this has made an individual to form a compound. There are two things. One is privacy, second is security. Privacy is entirely different from security. Anybody who is having his own area in which he wants to operate, within his own relations, within his own possessions, within his own inhibitions. Inhibitions are inner, relations are extended, possessions are expanded. It is that the formulation of sociology. It has made the people to make rooms, to make doors and locks, to make the compounds for their houses, to make iron grills and windows, everything he has made. This is something privacy. Then apart from that, the second issue is security. Privacy is their execution or their thing being unhindered by the society. And security, it is something in advanced level where there is a pose of threat or any danger by which they may be attributed some of the dangerous consequences of the non-social elements or the antisocial elements. So this has resulted in security. And now it has started with a person. Then it has become a social response. Then it has become national response. Then only it has resulted in technology. So let us start with persons. Basically, each and everybody, you know that if somebody touches you, immediately you respond to it. And somebody, they are not responsive, or somebody, they are hyper-responsive, somebody, they won't like somebody touching them at all, and somebody, they are moody, innumerable things are their responses. And there are some connected responses also. If somebody touches their sentiments, about caste, about religion, about language, about country, about their relations, about their personal thing. So these things are all expanding like that. In which there are two things. One is, if a person is responsive to all these various other instincts, then immediately he is a pakka human being. Human being is not devoid of any of these instinctive imbalance. Human being, it is a nature to have instinctive imbalance as well as to expose something to the society in the form of retaliation, reply, response or revenge, whatever it may be. Human beings are natural, but it is the duty of a human being to be an advanced human being and para-human in nature. There are a lot of natural things. For example, daily we are becoming dirty and we take baths. And daily we lose things and we used to gain them back. Likewise, the human being's tireless endeavor must be not to become just a human being, but to become an ideal human being or para-human. So naturally, this type of instinct inside the human being that blossoms into sentimental or violent aggression towards any person who is committing upon all of these things. There are two extremities. One person is totally like a stone, not bothering about anything. Second person is a dynamite who is waiting for a spark to explode. There is a big stone, and even if you lit fire, it won't explode. And the other thing is a very responsive dynamite or a camphor which is connected with the dynamite, immediately ready to burst and totally blister into pieces. So these things are the two extremities. Because of lack of mind governing tools and advancement of mind governing tools, advocation of mind governing tools in the national atmosphere, in the academic atmosphere, in the domestic atmosphere, in the social atmosphere, because of lack of all of these things, they have grown to such a tremendous state by which they are now blinking what to do next. Because this is not a level, because technology has advanced and everybody's time limit has been eroded by continuous motion towards wealth or wealth sustenance or power sustenance or health problems. So everybody's rate of growth or race for growth that has been hyper intensified, and there is no time, there is no tendency, there is no temper, there is no tackling the technicality, there is no methodology by which they can be brought to this impressionable stage by which they can be good receptacles of this type of knowledge. They have crossed the age, they have crossed the time limitation, everything. Now there is a time for us to bring all of these things. So personally, unless it starts from persons, for example, value impact is very much important in this personal analysis, very significant. Hundreds of people are here. All of us, hundreds of people, we have nothing to do by that, because we are just policy makers. That's what we used to say. We have been given only that limitation or that participation which is given to a goat or a person who is about to hang. If a person is about to be hung by an execution, what will be the question? He can pray and ask for his last wish. And there is a goat which is about to be sacrificed at the altar. What it can do? It can be garlanded and worshipped before that. That is the position of people. Because we have no direct impact with the society that we are going to discuss in the access theory. Persons who are going to do the defense, number one, persons who have been doing the offense, both the people are beyond our access. We are all just thinkers, good thinkers, but qualitatively and quantitatively, influentially, we are very limited. One, quantitative limitation, we are very, 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 very negligible in numbers. Qualitative limitations, we are all having qualities. Good qualities, good thoughts, and we are having lot of other execution plans. But qualitative impact of this thing in the society, which has advanced in a greater level in terror technology, this peace technology cannot intervene in such a stage where that is raising its ugly heads and it is dancing with full swing. The third thing is our impact, where we are going to reach. If I talk, how many people are going to listen? If hundreds of people they listen, how many people are going to follow? If hundreds of people are going to follow, how many people are going to follow it to the end of reaching and achieving the benefit? So this is known as impact study. So we have quantitative limitation, we have qualitative inadequacy, and we have a very, very infinitesimal impact into two things. That's what I told in one seminar, which is for cow protection. There were a lot of people discussing about cow slaughter. Then I told that all the people available here, they are all worshippers of cows. Nobody, no slaughter has been brought here.